Adam Mills joins us now from London. Well, great to have you back on the show, Adam. You talked in that clip about being an Aussie, but I should point out you have just been made a member of the Order of the British Empire. Wow. So congratulations, but does that mean you're more British than Aussie now?
Oh, absolutely. It changes everything, my mate. Do you know what I mean? Like, I talk completely differently now. I drink from a bottle. I call people geezer. I make rhyming slang that doesn't make any sense. Apples and pears, hundreds and thousands. It's all changed, mate.
And you play for West Ham. That's amazing. Congratulations on the book, Rockstar Detectives. This is extraordinary. You are now an author. You can officially say that. Were you not busy enough?
Do you know what? Funnily enough, I did have a lot on, and then I'm not sure if you're aware, but something happened a couple of years ago that stopped all live comedy in its tracks.
Yeah.
So, literally, the weekend that, that Melbourne went into a first lockdown, I got the contract through to write this children's book, and it was just a stroke of luck. And, in fact, I even thanked the Australian government in the acknowledgements because hotel quarantine was the perfect time to write a children's book.
Well, Adam, we're told it was a joint effort and your daughter actually came up with the idea. Is that right?
Yeah, that's true. So my eldest, who's now 11 but was 8 at the time when I started writing, she kind of came up to me one day quite concerned in the kitchen and said, "Daddy, I'm not sure when I grow up if I want to be a rock star or a detective." And I was like, well, I want to be really encouraging here. So I went, well, you could be both. You could be a rock star and a detective. You could go around the world doing shows and solving crimes. And then kind of went, that is not a bad idea for a children's book.
Can we confirm that this is the same daughter that did this to you?
No, it was the younger daughter that did that to me, I'll be honest. They have both contributed to the book, though. I ran the story past my eldest in particular, but then when it came time to design the cover, I showed her the original design and she was like, no, that font's wrong. No, I don't like those colours. Let's change that. Let's move that around. Honestly, she kind of contributed more than I did.
I noticed on your back, Hilsey, there was the words back poo. What is a back poo? Is all poo back poo?
You're right there.
I think one of them was informative and one of them was derogatory.
Mate, we know how much you love your music as well. Is there one, like, rock mystery that you would particularly love to solve yourself?
Oh, my goodness. Is there one rock mystery that I'd like to solve myself? Okay, Lennon or McCartney, which one of them was best? I don't know if that's a mystery for kids, but I think Peter Jackson's tried to do that in the Beatles documentary that's on at the moment. But what really went on in the early days? Who wrote all of those songs?
I'm 6 hours into that documentary and I still haven't gotten to Mordor yet, so it's pissing me off a bit. But, mate, this book really focuses on showing disability as an advantage, which wasn't always the case, you know, for you. So how important was it for you to be part of changing this conversation?
Hugely important. In particular, so the character of George in this book is in a wheelchair, but the first time it's mentioned, it's a positive. Because he's lower than everybody else, he sees Charlie on her own across the playground. Mm. And then because he's at a different height, he notices clues that nobody else sees. And it makes him faster when there's a chase in the book. So every mention of his wheelchair throughout the book is done in a positive way because it's an advantage. So I wanted it to be seen as a bit of a superpower. And I think the more, the more people are across the Paralympics, the more they're aware of disability and people with disabilities, the more they kind of go, actually, yeah. Do you know what? Yeah, you might be missing a bit, but I think you've got something extra going on as well.
Yeah, beautifully done, Hilsey. The book is called Rockstar Detectives. It's available now wherever you get good books. Adam Hills, thanks so much for joining us on the project.
Cheers. Thanks, guys.